Hello everybody, again on Simplyfoodea YouTube channel. Today we will continue the HACCP training material. Before we get entering to the seven principles of the HACCP, we must know a very important topic about this video is the difference between the hazard and the risk. How we can differentiate between the hazard and the risk. I'm giving small example about the hazard and risk. I'm getting the water gun. And we can imagine that the water is the hazard, okay? For example, when we have a water gun with the water inside and we have three paper walls, A and B and C, and we splash the water on these walls, the risk or the percent of the water splashing of the different wall. So there is, for example, low risk, the 30%, medium risk, the 60%, and high risk, the 90%. So the difference between the hazard and the risk, that the risk are the result from the hazard. Also, second thing, we are saying low and medium and high risk, but we are not saying low and medium and high hazard. But there is types of hazards with the potential to adversely affect health or business. There is five food safety hazard, the physical hazard, chemical hazard, biological hazard, allergens, and radiations. I will train you also in the upcoming videos how we can make a complete risk assessment for each raw material and each ingredient we have. So let's go directly to the principles of the HACCP, conducting the hazard analysis. We will have hazard risk assessment for the raw materials and ingredients, for the product and contact materials, and for the processes. Today, I will just explain for you how to can make a risk assessment. There is a small equation for the risk. The risk equal multiplying the severity with the likelihood or the probability. So the risk are the result of the equation of the multiplication of severity multiplied by the likelihood or the probability. The risk score or risk assessment result is a management tool to differentiate risks that may need to be controlled by the HACCP process. So when we can make the hazard analysis, we must have reference material for our hazard analysis and some of the cooperation of the HACCP team. This reference will be external information, even if it is epidemiological or information from the food chain or other food safety related data or from experience. Experience of what? Of the HACCP team which are holding all the risk assessment. So let's take a quick look about the HACCP team members. Who are they? There must be a top management. Quality department, either the quality assurance, quality control, food safety, or lab. Production, maintenance and engineering, purchasing and procurement, and finally the sales to help us if there is any recall for the product. So all this HACCP team are holding all the risk assessment. So how we can make risk assessment by ourselves and make it low, medium, and high? You will draw a table, 8x8, 8 columns multiplied by 8 rows, as this one, risk assessment control measure. I have mentioned before that it's the severity multiplied by the probability or likelihood. So first we'll take levels or degrees of the severity. Either it's negligible, so it takes number 1. Minor will take number 2. Moderate will take number 3. Major will take number 4, and extreme will take number 5. So we are taking some kind of levels or degrees. So let's go to the other axis, will be the likelihood or the probability. Very unlikely will take number 1. Rarely occur will take number 2. Possible will take 3. Likely occur will take 4. And occurs frequently will take 5. And we now will multiply the severity by the likelihood. As you can see, for example, this minor severity multiplied by rarely occur, the result will be 4. So we will continue multiplication, as you can see. So now we are having a table, the severity and the likelihood, but we must make if there is low risk, high risk, or medium risk, how we can make it so according to the HACCP team agreement, we'll say that from number one to number four, equation result or multiplication result will be low risk if it's from one to four. And if it's from 5 to 10, will be medium risk. And if it's from 12 to 25, it will be high risk. This table is very important to make any risk assessment you want, and according to also the decision from the HACCP team. You can try it by yourself. You can make it either minor or moderate and major. So it will be 1 to 3 multiplied by 1 to 3. Whatever you want, but you have must have three levels or at least two levels, low and high, so you can make your proper risk assessment. Good luck for all of you, and in the upcoming video I will explain some of the raw materials and packaging material for our orange juice example of the HACCP training material. Thank you very much, and if you like the content doesn't be boring for you, so please share it, and good luck for all of you, and thank you again.